इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
वुड यू लाइक टू प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ?
सर आई एम फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश। आई हैव बीएड इन 2001, पीएचडी इन 2010 एंड यूजीसी नेट इन 2014। माय रिसर्च टॉपिक इज लिटरेरी वैल्यू ऑफ नॉन फिक्शनल वर्क्स ऑफ सर बी एस नायपॉल। मोर ओवर एनदर बुक ऑन बी एस नायपॉल्स ट्रैवल एंड फाइव अदर रिसर्च पेपर्स हैव ऑल्सो बीन पब्लिश्ड इन डिफरेंट जर्नल्स।
ओके, कैन यू प्लीज टेल मी द नेम्स ऑफ टू ऑफ योर बेस्ट रिसर्च पेपर्स?
यस सर। वेरियस फेसेट्स ऑफ लव एज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन चेतन भगत्स हाफ गर्लफ्रेंड एंड सेकेंड वन द इमेज ऑफ इंडिया एज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन बी एस नायपॉल्स इंडियन ट्रिलॉजी।
ओके, सो व्हाट इज द इमेज ऑफ इंडिया दैट इज रिफ्लेक्टेड देयर?
सर इन इंडियन ट्रिलॉजी देर आर थ्री बुक्स एन एरिया ऑफ डार्कनेस इंडिया ए अबाउंडेड सिविलाइजेशन इंडिया ए मिलियन म्यूटिनी नाउ। इन द थ्री बुक्स द राइटर डिस्क्राइब्स द हार्श ही हैज शोन द हार्श ट्रीटमेंट टुवार्ड्स इंडिया। इन द फर्स्ट टू बुक्स है ही इज वेरी क्रिटिकल ऑफ इंडिया बट इन द थर्ड वन हिज मूड चेंजेस एंड ही शोज सम सिंपैथी एंड ही जस्टिफाइज द इंडियाज म्यूटनी और द स्ट्रगल फॉर फ्रीडम।
What are the parameters on which he criticizes India?
एक्चुअली सर ही हिज ग्रैंडफादर बिलोंग टू अवर बनारस एंड हिज एंसेस्टर हैव टोल्ड इंडिया अबाउट इंडिया एंड ही हैज डेवलप्ड एन ए डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ इमेज टुवार्ड्स इंडिया बट व्हेन ही केम टू इंडिया इन 1962 ही फाउंड हियर डर्ट स्क्वेलर करप्शन एटसेट्रा एंड ही फाउंड इंडिया क्वाइट डिफरेंट एज ही हैड द आइडिया इन हिज माइंड।
ओके, यू सेड योर दी रिसर्च थेसिस टाइटल इज लिटरेरी वैल्यू, राइट?
यस सर
ओके,
लिटरेरी वैल्यू।
व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय लिटरेरी वैल्यू?
सर लिटरेरी वैल्यू देर आर द सम देर आर मेनी जनरल जनरल पैरामीटर्स ऑफ लिटरेरी वैल्यू। सम ऑफ देम आर्टिस्टिक एक्सप्रेशन अपीलिंग पावर सजेस्टिविटी यूनिवर्सलिटी थॉट प्रोवोकिंग एक्सप्रेशन एंड ए टिंज ऑफ सम डीपर पर्पज
ओके,
कंटेम्परेरी।
अपीलिंग पावर, हाउ वुड यू डिफाइन अपीलिंग पावर?
सर ए राइटिंग बिकम्स अपीलिंग व्हेन इट अपील्स टू आवर इमोशन रादर देन एन इंटेलेक्ट। देर आर मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स सम ऑफ देम आर लव वंस लॉस्ट इज पेन दिस लाइन इज बाय सैली एंड हियर दिस लाइन डज नॉट डिस्क्राइब ए सिंपल फैक्ट बट इट अपील्स टू अवर द इमोशन ऑफ लव।
ओके, व्हाट इज द टेक्निक दैट वी एस नायपॉल यूजेस टू मेक हिज राइटिंग अपीलिंग? व्हाट मेथड डज ही यूज टू मेक हिज राइटिंग अपीलिंग?
सॉरी सर।
ओके, संतोष सर.
ओके मिस्टर अमरेश, वी एस नेपाल हैज बीन वेरी यू नो हैज बीन वेरी कंट्रोवर्शियल, और आई मे से वाज वेरी कंट्रोवर्शियल पर्सन इन रिलेशन टू इंडिया. जस्ट टेल मी टू कंट्रोवर्सीज दैट ही क्रिएटेड इन हिज लाइफ रिगार्डिंग द मिथ एंड कल्चर एंड यू कैन से पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू on India. Two controversies.
Actually, he was brought up in the Western culture, and he looked India through his Western eyes, but he had no deep knowledge about India. That's why his statesman.
I am asking two controversies. Just come to the point. Just tell me that two controversial statement he made on India.
One statement is he called India an area of darkness, and secondly he called India a wounded civilization.
Okay, had he ever indicted Indian political leaders or Indian politics or Indian idea of secularism, had he ever accused or raised any question regarding this in his life?
Sir, please repeat your question, sir, please.
Had he ever raised any question regarding the Indian secular point of view?
Yes, sir. Yes.
The idea of secularism. When and what was it?
He was not very happy about the India secularism.
Okay. And, okay. What is the popular literature and what is aesthetic literature? Just popular, tell me the difference between popular literature and aesthetic literature.
Popular literature is I am not aware about this question, sir, at this time.
What is transitive and intransitive verb?
Transitive and intransitive verbs. So transitive verbs are those that wear object. Intransitive are the opposite of its, okay, opposite.
Give us two examples. One from transitive and one from intransitive.
Okay, sir. I play in the field. In this sentence, the verb play is intransitive. I play cricket in the field. In this sentence, the play is transitive.
Okay. What is willing suspension of disbelief?
Yes, sir. This phrase is very popular, and it was coined by S.T. Coleridge in his work Biographia Literaria, published in 1817. This phrase means the writer makes us. When the reader suspends his disbelief about the superstitions. For example, everybody knows a man cannot fly, but when it is shown in a literature, he believes.
Is there any difference between magical realism and a willing suspension of disbelief? Have you heard the word, the quote, or the phrase magical realism?
Yes, sir, I have heard, but not sound knowledge I have at this time about magic realism.
Okay.
All right.
Is there any particular writer you love the most or you have very good interest in?
Yes, sir, John Keats. I like John Keats, sir.
Okay, John Keats. So, which ode of John Keats you like the most?
Sir, Evergreen. It is an ode to a nightingale, sir.
Ode to a nightingale. Okay. So, how can you say that it is an ode?
Because it is in address form. And it is in address form, and it is a regular word.
I asked the question that how can you say that it is an ode?
Sir, it is in the format of a typical ode, sir.
Again, I am asking how can you say that it is an ode?
Sorry, sir. Sorry.
Okay, that's all from my side.
Okay, Priya, would you like to ask any question to Amresh ji?
Okay, sir. So I would like to ask that What is the major thing of Keats' writing which makes him different from Shelley and other romantic writers?
His dominant feature is sensuousness.
Okay, and can you tell us something about the letters he wrote to his one relative, and what was the major theory he was discussing over there in those letters?
In which letter, ma'am?
Sir, he was writing some letters to one of his relatives,
Yes, sir. Yes,
and
ma'am.
he was discussing one major theory related to his writing. So, what the theory was about?
Yes, nice question. It was the negative capability.
Okay, that's all, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so can you explain the negative capability?
Yes, sir. Negative capability is a phrase coined by John Keats in a letter to his two brothers, George and Thomas, on 21st April 1817. In the letter, he defined negative capability. A person possesses it when he is capable of bearing uncertainties, mysteries, and doubts without any irritable facts after facts and reason. In negative capability, the poet has no individuality of his own. He becomes one with the object he is describing. It shows the writer's total detachment and objectivity. A fine example is of negative capability, Ode to a Nightingale, in which he describes musing on the mortality. He has no individuality in the poem, except.
Okay, Amresh ji, just tell me one question, that in Ode to a Nightingale, when does he reach to that zenith and to that top of negative capability? Is there any particular point?
Or the line that you can quote.
From the Ode to the Nightingale.
Yes.